Yo, 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 welcome back once again to the CPA Strength Show. And who are you, CPA Strength? I'm the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. That's who I am. And what do you do over here, buddy? I educate, motivate, and inspire people on a daily basis by counting, by teaching them accounting, building blocks, basics, building blocks, building blocks, building blocks. Now, I will show you this little, actually it's a big playlist. I'm just gonna, it's right here. It'll make all your dreams come true. It's the best playlist in the world, guaranteed. I guarantee it'll make all your dreams come true. It's really like nothing else. It's like a molecule, like a neutron. Like, have you seen one of those before? You've heard of them. This is kind of what that is. Alrighty, anyways. This is number 71 of my classic series. Classic series. And we're doing a break-even point example. We've been talking about break-even point. What is break-even point? It's when your revenue equals your cost. And that's how we're going to start out with it. Because if you can't remember anything else, if you can't quite remember the formula for it, we're just going to start. Break-even point example. The first question is we're going to find a break-even point in sales units. And the second question we have is we're going to find the break-even point in sales units, but we're just going to change the sales price to 67. And in the first example, the sales price is 60. So it's just more practice for us to do. And that's, quite frankly, that's how you're going to learn the break-even, like if you don't know it. You're gonna do, one question one day, and then 2 weeks later, you're not really gonna remember it. If you do two questions a day, every day, for 2 weeks, and mind you, by the time you're doing a break-even question in that second week, it's gonna take you like 2 seconds. Like, you're just gonna look at it and be like, oh, boop, boop, boop. And guess what, when you get on your test, it's boop, boop, boop. Anyway, so we're going to do these two different things. Now, I want to say, what is the break-even point? It's when revenues, right, rev equals costs. And I want to start out first with my algebraic equation. And then we're going to do it with the formula. And then we're going to solve the formula's answer on how many units we need to break even. I'm going to solve that with the algebraic equation. Anyways, revenue minus costs, that's a break-even point, right? How much money we have coming in equals how much money we have going out. What do we have coming in? What's our revenue? Our revenues are $60 per unit. So it's going to be 60 times how many units we sell equals the variable, our cost equals our cost. What's our cost? Our variable cost, 35 per unit. 35, depending on how many units we sell, plus fixed cost of 80,000. So when we sell a unit, we get $60 coming in per unit. Also, when we sell a unit, we have $35 per unit coming out of our bank. And not included in the variable cost, not included in our cost, is the fixed costs of $80,000. So we got variable costs and fixed costs that comprise of our costs. Now, what is the formula? Well, the formula is fixed. Do you know the formula? It's fixed over contribution margin. What's contribution margin? Sales minus variable. Right, that's the contribution margin. Because think about it, what are we doing here? We're selling a product, we're selling a widget for $60. And the cost associated with that item, with that one item in particular, that one item, not the straight cost, not the fixed costs, like rent and a cable and a internet bill, not the fixed ones. So $35 is coming out each time we sell. We got $60. We got $60 coming in each time we sell a unit, but we have $35 going out. So that means there's $25 in profit every single time. There's $25 in profit, then the fixed costs. So that is called the contribution margin, the sales minus the variable costs. And once we have the contribution margin, which in this case is $25 a piece, then we can divide that into the fixed cost, because then we'll know how many units we have to sell to make up for that fixed cost. Now, if this isn't making sense to you and you don't understand the break-even cost, you know, play with some numbers yourself and sit there for, you know, that's my thing. Slow down a little bit. Think about what's going on. Try to think about the big picture. Work it till you understand it. Don't worry that someone else can learn this in seemingly 20 minutes, okay? It might take you 2 days, but guess what? You're gonna go slow, and once you learn it, you learn it. Anywho, I'm gonna start going a little faster now, all right? I'm sorry about all this. What's fixed? Fixed is 80K, right? 80,000. And what's the contribution margin? The contribution margin is sales minus variable, 60 minus 35, right? 60 minus 35 is 25. So 80,000 divided by 25. What did I say? 80,000 divided by 25. I got 3,200. I got 3,200 units it'll take to break even. I got 3,200 units. That's my answer. If you sold at $60 per unit. The contribution margin is 25, so it's $80,000 by 25. $80,000 by $25. 3,200 units. Would that work over here? Would 3,200 units satisfy this equation? And you're darn tootin', I would 100% check the validity of this. All right, so $60 revenue, 60 times 3,200 units equals 192,000. 192,000, okay. So we want these to equal 192K. And this is with 3,200 units in there. We're just checking the validity of 192K, $60 times 3,200. Now that's our revenue. Now if we sold 3,200 units, would that equal 192,000 in our cost? Let's find out. $35 per unit. Let's clear up. $35 per unit times 3,200 times 3,200 equals 112,000 plus 80,000 plus 80,000 is 192,000. So yes, that checks out. That checks out. Bing, bing, bing. Now I'm kind of running out of time. I'm sweaty AF. Let me just run through this real fast. I'm just gonna run through this real fast. So the answer to number one is 3,200, okay? Number two, we're gonna change the sales price. We're gonna change the sales price from 60 to 67, all right? So revenue's gotta equal costs, right? Rev equals costs. Now each one, our revenue is gonna be 67 now, times how many units we sell to break even is gonna equal. Well, we got the same cost, 35 variable and 80,000 fixed. So it's going to be, our costs are going to be $35 times every time we sell one of these plus 80,000. Same facts as before. I was just looking at the lighting, sorry. Okay, let's go on to, what are we going to go on to now? I can't think because I'm sweating. It is middle of August 2017. Hopefully, I can look back at this another 10 years or something, you know, and the year, you know, 2027 or 2025, and have a nice place with lots of air conditioning and say, you know what? You just grinded, boss. And yeah, man. I mean, hopefully I'll look back at this and be like, man, I loved that time, and I was just grinding, man, I'm just grinding. So anyways, right now I'm hating it. Right now I feel like I'm gonna die. Woo! Alright, where was I? Alright, so that's the algebraic equation. Now we're just gonna solve for, how do we solve for break-even? Fixed over contribution margin. What's our fixed? 80,000. 80,000 is fixed over, what's our contribution margin? 67 now minus 35 is 32. I hope it's 32. Ooh, 32, I hope it is. I don't know. Let's see, I see this is 7 more, and we just added 7, so yeah, I know it's right. I don't know it's right, players. All right, let's go. Let's go. 80,000 divided by 32 equals 2,500. 2,500 is what you would need to sell to break even. Would that make sense? Because would that make sense? If you raise the price $7 per unit, so you're making more per unit, you would have to sell less to cover your costs. Yes, that would make sense. Now, let's take this 2,500 and put it in here. And see if it works out. Let's see, if we sold 2,500 of these units. Come on. 67 times 2,500. That's 167,500. 167,500. That's how much revenue you'd have at selling 2,500 units. Now, what would your cost be? $35 times 2,500 equals $87,500 plus $80,000 plus $80,000 equals $167,500. 167,500. Oh my God, I don't even want to talk about the heat anymore. I want to talk about staying positive. That's what I really want to talk about. And I was listening to some Tony Robbins before I started, when I was doing this board here. It says, listen, I took some notes. Whatever you look for is what you get. Think about that, all right? I wrote that down. That means whatever you look for is what you get. Also, most people overestimate what can be done in a year, and they underestimate what can be done in 10 years. So just work your butt off and stay positive, and I'll see you in the next one, all right? Like, comment, share, subscribe. Don't be stingy with all this accounting stuff. Actually, if you share it with someone who's taking accounting, I'm not stingy with this accounting knowledge, so you don't be stingy either, and I'll see you in the next one. I'll see you for 72. Deuces.